In epsilon, epsilon can be obtained from page 44. Page 44. Page 44, there is a table 5.2. In the bottom of the table, there is epsilon. Epsilon can be selected according to fi value. We found fi value, it is 235. So our epsilon value is 1. Here. Then classification of cross section. This classification of cross section is very important because we'll do design. Then we will do design for steel, and here is a compression extent of cross section and buckling. There are several checks for these sections. We will need class of the cross section. So this is very important. Before doing design, we have to classify our cross section. So you just go to page 44. It's the same page that we used before. So in this table, we can classify the cross section. How to do it? We use this column, part subjected to compression. So there are relationships. First, we have to satisfy these requirements. If this is not satisfied, we will check this requirement. If this is satisfied, class is class 1. Okay. This requirement is COT less than or equal 33 times epsilon. What is C? You can see it in this diagram. This is square of friction. C is the distance between these plates. So this is C is not the overall depth of the section. So we can calculate it. We can calculate it. C equals 50 minus 2 times 5. Answer is 40 millimeters. And thickness is 5. We obtain from section properties, and 40 divided by 5, 8. So class limit 33 times epsilon. It is came from this 33 times epsilon equals 33. So 8 less than 33, so 8 less than 33, so the section is class 1. So we classified our section, it is class 1. So then we will see how to check compression resistance of the cross section. Compression resistance of the cross section can be satisfied or can be checked using this course, or you can go to this page 51. Page 51. Yes, tension, not tension. We'll check for compression. Because we check compression. So this is our course for 6.2.4 compression. In this course, there is a requirement. We have to satisfy this requirement. Then we will see what are the mean of these parameters. NED. NED is the compression force or tension force. So in this case, we will check compression. So NED is the maximum compression force. Other one is NCRD. What is NCRD? NCRD. You can see here the design resistance of the cross section for uniform compression NCRD should be determined as follows. So we have to use this relationship for this relationship, but we classify our cross section. I told you we will need this class, so here it is. This is class 1, 2, 3. So our cross section class is class 1. We have to use this relationship. It means NCRD equals AFI over gamma n naught. So this is NED. This is compression force, maximum compression force. And then we have to decide, we have to determine these parameters.